Hey y'all, February 25th of reading through your Bible chronologically in 1 year. We read Leviticus 25 through 26. My mom's here. Say hello, Mom.
Hello, Mom.
Yay. Okay, so what I want us to think about as we're reading through this and going over this is looking for a God of redemption. I'm going to point some things out, but a God of redemption meaning that he is out to redeem. He's out to buy back something that was lost, okay? So we're looking for that heart where he is calling things back to himself. So in chapter 25, the rest of chapter 25, that first section, we see the redemption of property. And the second section, we see the redemption of the poor and the enslaved. And so when we see that, we go, okay, God wants to give the opportunity for us to be called back. And for us in New Testament times, we are already walking in relationship with him. We're not going to lose him. However, we can shut him out. We can hold a piece of our heart away from him, a piece of our lives. Like, that's just too much. I can't give you that. I can't even think about it. But God continues to call into that place and say, give it to me. I want to free you from it, because that's what this was. The year of Jubilee was a year of freedom. People got freed from slavery. People got to go back to their land. It was a year of freedom. And so that's what God is calling into in your life when he's asking to get a hold of those dark hidden places, is he's wanting to redeem them and free you from them. So my first question to you today is ask God that. Ask God, is there anything in my life that you're wanting to redeem that I'm holding back from you? Then in chapter 26, we see a blessing for obedience. Sorry, my dog is barking in his sleep. Blessing for obedience and a punishment for disobedience. And so we see a list again of things that God wants the Israelites to do and not do. The first is he is asking them to be devoted, to observe, that's the word I'm looking for, observe the Sabbath and for reverence. And then in verse 5, he tells them, if you do this, you will live securely. In verse 6, he says he's going to give them peace in the land. In 9, he says, I will look favorably upon you and you will bear children. And 12, he says, I will walk among you. And so obviously, or maybe not so obviously, I don't know, that's not exactly how it looks these days. We know that we can be walking with the Lord and not be able to get pregnant. We know that we can be walking with the Lord and feel scared. And so when we look at this through New Testament filters, when it says live securely, we can feel God's presence and feel like we know, I know that God is taking care of me, and that gives us a sense of security and peace. He says his perfect love drives out fear. And so when we are receiving that love, we have peace even in the midst of really hard circumstances. We're fruitful. We've talked about that in reference to the fruits of the Spirit, loving, joyful, peaceful, those kinds of things. And we're aware of God's presence in our life. And so we are able to hear from him and receive whatever it is he's wanting to give us. And that is the picture of the abundant life that he talks about in John 10, 9, and 10. If you can go look that up. It's God saying, I came to give them life to the full. And that's what full life is life with Christ, a life of peace and security and favor and presence, all of those things. So that's what we're wanting. And it talks about Jesus being our shepherd also in that little scripture in John 10, 9, and 10. So we're not meant to live as slaves, as we'll see in the very next verse. In verse 13, it says, I am the Lord your God who brought you out of the land of Egypt so you would no longer be their slaves. I broke the yoke of slavery from your neck so you can walk with your heads held high. That is why Christ came, to free us. And so he doesn't want us living in disobedience, which also equals slavery. In Galatians 5:1, it says, For freedom Christ has set us free. Stand firm, therefore, and do not submit again to a yoke of slavery. So we are free in Christ, but we can willingly bend the knee to things in our life. So ask God, what am I bending the knee to that you would want to free me from today? I want to live that abundant life that you died to give me. And then the rest of chapter 26 is punishment for disobedience. So if they don't listen and they don't obey, there are things like wasting disease. So maybe being depleted in New Testament times, planting their crops in vain. So maybe being unfruitful in New Testament times, working, 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 and seeing no fruit. Then defeat, loneliness, hunger. We can have this spiritual hunger going on inside of us that never seems to be, we never seem to get full or fulfilled. Desolation, ruin, fear. Those are the results. Those are the fruits of disobedience. So the question to us is, do we want to live in obedience and have the fruit of blessing, or do we want to live in disobedience and have the fruit of punishment and this stuff right here that we have no interest in? Nobody wants to sit around and be defeated and unfruitful and lonely, right? So if we can ask God today again, am I being disobedient somewhere? Show me where that is so that I can give that to you and be walking closely with you. So his heart, all of these punishments, you'll notice over and over again, he keeps saying, if you still don't obey me, or if you still disobey, I'm going to keep going. And it's to bring us back into that close relationship. It's out of that redemptive heart. He's trying to draw us back into him. So what I have done for probably over 2 years is ask God, show me your love. I mean, because sometimes you look a different way to me. I know, the truth is, I know that you say you're loving. So God, show me that you love me. And pray it every day until you believe it. And he will show you that he loves you and he is a redemptive God and a loving God. That is it for today. So tomorrow is... what's tomorrow? February 26th. You'll be reading Leviticus 27 and Numbers 1. Talk to you then. Bye.